Welcome to St. Elizabeth Catholic Church on this 14th Sunday in Ordinary Time. A special welcome to those who are joining us from their homes. Our presider at this Mass is Father Francisco. Please now all stand and together let us sing our entrance song, Glory and Praise to our God.
Brothers and sisters, this weekend we are celebrating two festivities. One is our patronal festivity dedicated to St. Elizabeth, Portugal, and independence of the United States. We pray for our country and pray for our parish community, for each one of you. We remember in this Mass Arnaldo Abito for healing, Mariano Corpus too, and safety and protection of children of our parish, our deceased loved ones, Anna Tranti Nuet, Marta Buthi Mintu, Feliciana Pacaña, Eileen Velasco, Remedios Evasco, Francisco Evasco, Viviana Hayag, Terence Lloyd Dow, Pilar Laya, Faisal Iquiba, Angela Rosaline, and those who die from coronavirus, that God may grant them eternal rest. We pray for all of them, and I pray for each one of your intentions. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
God sent Jesus Christ to bring peace to the world. His servant, St. Elizabeth, Portugal, worked for justice and peace. They ask that the Lord's work continue in us, following St. Elizabeth's example. May the grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
And with your spirit.
And coming together as God's family with confidence, let us ask the Lord forgiveness for his full of gentleness and compassion.
Lord, your word bring comfort to the suffering. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, your word give wisdom to the seeker. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, your word lead us to holy life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Thank you.
Son, have raised up a fallen world. Fill your faithful with holy joy, for on those you have rescued from slavery to sin, you bestow eternal gladness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Zechariah. Thus says the Lord, rejoice heartily, O daughter Zion. Shout for joy, O daughter Jerusalem. See, your king shall come to you. A just savior is he, meek and riding on an ass, on a colt, the foal of an ass. He shall banish the chariot from Ephraim and the horse from Jerusalem. The warrior's bow shall be banished, and he shall proclaim peace to the nations. His dominion shall be from sea to sea, and from the river to the ends of the earth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Forever, my King and my
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, you are not in the flesh. On the contrary, you are in the Spirit, if only the Spirit of God dwells in you. Whoever does not have the Spirit of Christ does not belong to him. If the Spirit of the one who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, the one who raised Christ from the dead will give life to your mortal bodies also, through his Spirit that dwells in you. Consequently, brothers and sisters, we are not debtors to the flesh to live according to the flesh. For if you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the deeds of the body, you will live. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
At that time, Jesus exclaimed, "I give praise to you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for although you have hidden these things from the wise and the learned, you have revealed them to little ones. Yes, Father, such has been your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart, and you will find rest for yourselves, for my yoke is easy and my burden light." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Brothers and sisters, last year we were together celebrating the festivity of our parish in a picnic and having the mass in the park. It was a beautiful celebration, but in this year, different circumstances are happening and probably we have to wait. I don't know how long, but in faith and hope, we will be together again under God's protection. It is in Christ that we find perfect freedom and the fullness of hope. No one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. These words from Jesus indicate two things. First, only in Jesus do we find the fullness of revelation of God. As the Catechism states, in many and various ways God spoke of old to our fathers by the prophets. But in these last days, he has spoken to us by a Son, Christ, the Son of God made man, is the Father's one, perfect and unsurpassable word. In him, he has said everything. There will be no other word than this one. Listen to him. Second, Christ chooses to reveal the Father to us and to mediate that experience in relationship by shining a light for our feet to follow, and by walking beside us in our journey. Therefore, his instruction to all of us who are burdened and who labor to come to him and to take his yoke upon ourselves is meant to alert us to our being literally bound to him, coupled to him, so that he may help us pull and plow our way to the fields we walk. We can rest when we allow him to manage that yoke and do the heavy work. Sometimes we are working so hard without the Lord's presence, without invoking him. It's so heavy. Because the humans has no power to live with many problems in life. But under God's guidance and protection is what Saint Elizabeth of Portugal did. It's not easy to live with human problems, divisions, disunion. But Saint Elizabeth understood this, putting some of his heart in the work the Lord Jesus Christ called her to do with family and problematic situations in the community. This is another way of him saying, take up our cross and follow him. While it is true that we must do that, in this case, the message is that when we yoke ourselves to Christ in baptism and through our life of faith and in the sacraments, grace abounds and there is more room for Christ to work in our lives. The grace of the Lord worked through Saint Elizabeth Portugal always, and she allowed him to come and help her in this difficult work. Pastoral work. There is more room for Christ to lead the way and fewer opportunities for us to stumble over rocks in our path. Jesus, the Lord Jesus Christ, does not say we will no longer have struggles, but that he will find recourse in him. His strength will be our strength, infusing us with trust and helping us place all our difficulties before him. And when we commit ourselves to him, we become one with him. It's not just me or you working, it's Jesus Christ in us, working all together, one with him, with the Father whom he has revealed to us, and with the Holy Spirit, who gives us the gift of faith, marked by the sign of the cross by which Christ claims us as his own. We can look about this world and know that there are many who continue to walk alone, bereft of hope. They mistakenly believe that to take Christ's yoke upon them means that they are somehow limiting the freedom But it is just the opposite. Christ tells us his yoke is easy and his burden light. It is in him and the life of faith bound up with him that we find perfect freedom and the fullness of hope. In Jesus, he has given us the way, and this way is freely and humbly given. Let us pray, my brothers and sisters, to our patron saint, San Elizabeth of Portugal, intercede for us. And may the grace of God be with all of you. Amen.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, let us say our profession of faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten and made, substantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. My brothers and sisters, God sent Jesus to bring peace to the world. His servant, St. Elizabeth, Portugal, worked for justice and peace. Today we ask that the Lord's work continue in us, following St. Elizabeth's example.
For the church, may we follow in the footsteps of Jesus, feeding the hungry, welcoming the stranger, caring for the sick, visiting the outcast, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For peace throughout the world. May conflicts and jealousies end, and all nations use the resources to defeat disease and hunger, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who give of themselves, so that others may be helped, healthcare workers, home caregivers, police officers, firefighters, grocers, truckers, store clerks, mail carriers, takeout cooks, building cleaners, child care workers, and countless others, may they receive your protection as they serve, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who suffer, that they may find their way in life, allowing themselves to be touched by the heart of Jesus, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our community, as we join our prayers with those of St. Elizabeth the Peacemaker, who gave her life and health to avert the miseries of war, may we too develop a sincere charity towards others, a clean mind, and a brave heart, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those remembered at this Mass, may they know God's peace and love, especially our Nato Habito for healing, and for the safety and protection of the children of our parish, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our deceased loved ones, particularly Anatron Thiv Nguyen, Martha Vu Thi Minh Tu, Visliciana Pecania, Alan Velasco, Remedios Ivasco, Francisco Ivasco, Bibiana Hayag, Terence Lloyd Dow, Pilar Laya, Fazil Iqbal, and Angelina Rosalind, and those who've died from coronavirus, that God may grant them eternal rest, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayers.
And we pray for our country in this celebration of independence, for freedom, peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, you give us your holy ones for encouragement. Hear our prayers and help us to follow you more closely through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And sisters, pray with me that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of his holy church.
May this oblation dedicated to your name purify us, O Lord, and day by day bring our conduct closer to the life of heaven through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raise up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so with all the angels, we praise you as in joyful celebration, we acclaim. May holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, offer you, Lord, the bread of life and chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis, our Pope, Oscar, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life and may praise and glorify through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Is I leave you my peace, I give you. Look not on sins, but on the faith of the Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sigh of peace.
Thank you.
the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
I invite all of you who are at home to say the spiritual communion with us. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that having been replenished by such great gifts, we may gain the prize of salvation and never cease to praise you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
A prayer to our Holy Mother. O Mary.
O Mary, you shine continuously on our journey.
As a sign of salvation and hope, we entrust ourselves to you, help of the sick, who at the foot of the cross were united with Jesus' suffering and persevered in your faith. Protect us, O Roman people. You know our needs, and we know that you will provide, so that as the coming of Galilee, joyous celebration of your return after this time of trial. Help us, Mother of divine love, to conform ourselves to the will of the Father and to do what Jesus tells us, for he took upon himself our suffering and burdened himself with our sorrows, to bring us to the cross, the joy of resurrection. We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God, to satisfy our petitions in our necessities, but deliver us always from every danger. O glorious and blessed Virgin. Amen.
We have any announcements? No? Next weekend? Yes, you will receive through the internet and bulletin electronically the change of the masses next Sunday. Saturday and Sunday we'll have masses outdoors and gathering with 25 people in front. We will have mass at 4 p.m., 5:30, 7 p.m. This will be 4 in English, 5:30 in Vietnamese, 7 in Spanish, and Sunday, 8 a.m. in English, 9:30 in English, 11 in Vietnamese, and 12:30 in Spanish. Just check and please call the telephone number to reserve your seat and take your chair with you. Will be great. Thank you so much, and I wish to you this long weekend, peaceful celebration at home with your family, many blessings this sharing time. Father Vincent and Deacon, wish all of you independence celebration in freedom, love, and peace. Do you want to say something, Father? No?
You said already.
Okay, but all of us, ministries, wish all the families a good and nice celebration. God bless you. Take care of yourselves. And may the divine providence at the beginning of this month be with all of you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
And the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of Christ by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Have a beautiful week.
Thank you. Thank you.